Good luck, guys. Thanks.
Thank you.
World of Outlaws NOS Energy Drink Sprint Car Series. Chalk stripe has been applied to the racing surface, and that is where the green flag will wave the next time by. Landon Brooks alongside Buddy Copeland in row one. David Gravel and John Goodyear from row two. Rock Serfoss and Lockie McDonough in row three. Caden Steele, DJ Neto from row four. Mariah Eade and Garrett Williamson in row number five. Top six go to the feature. First and second advance to the Toyota Dash. Toyota Pace truck makes its way into the infield. And the caution lights go out on the speedway, and the Toyota Pace truck will dive into the infield. Landon Brooks alongside Buddy Copeland in row one, David Gravel and John Goodyear in row two. Then it is now Lockie McDonough and Caden Steele in row number three. Green flag waving again on egress number one. Fantastic start for Landon Brooks, and an opportunity for David Gravel as he looked for a move to the inside of Buddy Copeland, but Copeland strong at one and two to maintain the second spot. Landon Brooks leads lap number one. Buddy Copeland in close pursuit, running second. David Gravel is third. John Goodyear fourth, and now DJ Neto inside of Lockie McDonough. Battle for the lead out of turn number four. Copeland takes the top spot away. Landon Brooks trying to come right back at him, but nearly gets the car sideways to the midpoint between one and two. Caden Steele running in the seventh spot, trying to take the final transfer position from the six of Lockie McDonough, but now Steele feeling some pressure from the 3Z of Brock Zierfoss. Zierfoss will look to the inside, can't make the pass there. Lockie McDonough in the Bill Rose Motorsports number six, occupying the sixth and final transfer spot as we approach the halfway point in heat race number one. Brock Zierfoss jumps up to the top of the speedway, trying to get a run on Caden Steele for the seventh position. Halfway for the race leader. Five down and five laps to go. Buddy Copeland leads. Landon Brooks second. David Gravel runs third. John Goodyear fourth. DJ Neto and Lockie McDonough in the transfer spots. Buddy Copeland turning laps nearly in the 10-second bracket here in e-race competition. Three to go this time with Roth Motorsports number 83. Closing in on the back of the field as he catches up with the 14 of Mariah Eve. Copeland looks to the inside of the lead out of turn four. The two to go signal shown to the race leader. Copeland puts Mariah Eve a lap down. Buddy Copeland having his way with the field after risking the lead from Landon Brooks early on in this one. Takes it down the backstretch and into three and four for the final time. Buddy Copeland will win the opening heat race of the evening. Landon Brooks is in the Toyota Dash with the second place run. David Gravel finishes third. John Goodyear in fourth. Then goes to DJ Neto. And Lockie McDonough hangs on for that sixth and final transfer spot. Buddy Copeland, the winner in the 83. Second, the 45 of Landon Brooks. Third, the number two of David Gravel. Fourth, 57 of the feature. 1S of Logan Shewhart, the 83V of Dylan Bloomfield from the front row. 41S Dominic Selzy, 7S Landon Crawley in row two. 17, Sheldon Hodgschultz. 17, AU Jamie Field in row three. The 10 of Dominic Gordon and the 3 of Caleb Montgomery in row four. Logan Shewhart and Dylan Bloomfield lead the drivers down the backstretch for the Milton Hershey School's second heat race as the Toyota Pace truck makes its way into the infield. Green and go for the Milton Hershey School. heat race. Dylan Bloomfield jumps out to the early race lead, but the caution flag will wave. We've got cars scattered on the front stretch, and Sheldon Hottenshield, Toyota pace truck, rolls to the infield. Quick pace set by Logan Sheward and Dylan Bloomfield as we wave the green flag of the Milton Hershey School second heat race. Bloomfield jumps out to the race lead. Dominic Selzy to the inside, takes the third spot away. Landon Crawley, and now Crawley drifts up the racetrack, an opportunity down low for the three of Kale Montgomery, but Montgomery not able to take advantage. Sheldon Hockshield back from the fourth row into a transfer spot at the end of lap number one. Sheldon working the top side of the speedway. Dominic Gordon trying to work his way back to the inside of the NOS energy drink entry. Sheldon now sets his sights on Caleb Montgomery, who currently runs in the fifth position. He has a run on the number three down the back straightaway. Now turns to the inside of the speedway, but not enough room down there to make the pass for the fifth. Sheldon Hodgson back on the high side in one and two, trying to get another run on Caleb Montgomery. On the inside in three and four, pulls even, cannot complete the pass there. He'll go back to the top in one and two. Halfway this time by for the race leader, Dylan Bloomfield. We watch Sheldon Hodgson trying to take the fifth spot away from Caleb Montgomery. Unsuccessful so far in that attempt. Dominic Gordon just behind them, running in the seventh position. Leader now completes lap number 6 of 10. Dylan Bloomfield out in front by 7/10 of a second over Logan Sheward. Dominic Selzy running third. Landon Crawley fourth. Caleb Montgomery fifth. Sheldon Hodgson in sixth. That is Dominic Gordon and Jamie Veal. Slower pace set by the race leader in heat race number 2 than we saw in the opening heat race. Saw lap times there in the 11.1 second bracket. We're in the mid-11s here in the Milton Hershey School second heat race. Sheldon Hodgson continuing to try to find a way by the three of Caleb Montgomery, but unable to get by for the fifth spot. White flag waving for Dylan Bloomfield. Bloomfield looking for a spot in tonight's Toyota Dash, negotiates three and four for the final time. Dylan Bloomfield picks up the Milton Hershey School second heat race win. Logan Sheward second, Dominic Selzy third, Landon Crawley fourth, Caleb Montgomery fifth, and Sheldon Hodgson in sixth. Official order of finish for the Milton Hershey School second heat race. Dylan Bloomfield wins it in the 83V, second the 1S of Logan Sheward, third in the 41S of Dominic Selzy. Finishing fourth the 7S of Landon Crawley, fifth in car number 3. In row 2, 0 Tim Canning in the 15 of Johnny Johnson make up row 3, 70 Craig Kitzer, 88 Oscar Carl in row 4, with Dawson Faria at the rear of the field. Green flag set to wave on the final heat race of the night for the World of Outlaws NOS Energy Drink Sprint Car Series. Side by side down the front stretch. Giovanni Selzy to the race lead on the attack. The 41 of Carson Macedo. Macedo a quick peek to the inside, but nothing doing there. Hot Sauce leads lap number 1. Carson Macedo second. Younger brother Cole runs in the third spot. Donnie Schultz in fourth. Bill Baylog fifth. Tim Canning now in the sixth and final transfer spot is on the outside looking in, just behind him, the number 70 of Craig Kitzer. Kitzer a peek to the inside and a return one. Can't rest that final transfer spot for the Williams Motorsports number 0. Giovanni Selzy lap times in the low 11 second bracket, 11.3 so far. Four laps down and six laps to go. Advantage 8/10 of a second over second place, Carson Macedo. Cross flags now. Five laps complete, five laps remaining in our final heat race. Giovanni Selzy leading, and Carson Macedo runs second. Cole Macedo in the third spot. Donnie Schultz running fourth. Will Baylog fifth, and Tim Canning sixth. Those drivers in transfer spots. Then it's Craig Kitzer running seventh. Oscar Carl, eighth, and Dawson Faria in ninth. Carson Macedo getting a little bit closer to the race leader, has cut the Cody Selzy, but also running out of time. There will be two laps to go as the leader crosses the start-finish line. Giovanni Selzy through 3 and 4, down to the white flag. Less than a quarter of a mile remaining. The man who went to victory lane here 2 years ago. Selzy into turn 3. Out of corner number 4 to the checkered flag. And Giovanni Selzy wins the third heat race. Carson Macedo finishes second. Cole Macedo in third. Donnie Schultz fourth. Bill Balog fifth. Final transfer spot goes to Tim Kading. They finish our final heat race in this order. Giovanni Selzy wins it in car number 18, second the 41 of Carson Macedo, third the 21 of Cole Macedo, fourth the 15 of Donnie Schultz, fifth the 7.
What you think, Caleb?
No idea. I just said it, another California night with the World of Outlaws, another hammer down dyno sesh.
It's not even that bad. It'll blow off.
Not as much as I wanted it to.
Dude, you're a heavy track here. You should be grateful at the water track.
Carson Macedo and Dylan Bloomfield in row 2, Logan Shorn and Buddy Cope 1 from row 3. Winner on the pole for tonight's Nashville West Showdown with the World of Outlaws NOS Energy Drink Sprint Car Series. Landon Brooks and Gio Selzy bring us to the green flag in the Toyota Dash. Landon Brooks jumps to the race lead. Giovanni Selzy in hot pursuit down the backstretch. Logan Schuhart coming after the 41 of Carson Macedo for third. Digs down low. Macedo able to fend off that challenge at least for the moment. Now Macedo coming after Selzy for second out of the second corner. Macedo down low. Giovanni Selzy up on the top. And now Selzy's going to run on the race leader, Landon Brooks. 2 of 8 laps complete in the Toyota Dash. Action all over the Bakersfield Speedway. Selzy with a run on the top out of turn number 4. Hot Sauce takes the lead. Landon Brooks right back to his inside, keeping pace. Giovanni Selzy leads the Toyota Dash. Landon Brooks runs in the second spot at the halfway point. Buddy Copeway third, Carson Macedo fourth, and Logan Schwartz and Dylan Bloomfield. Now the race for second. Copeway to the inside. Oh, things got very tight there in the fourth quarter. Buddy Copeway unable to wrest the second position away from Wheatley Motorsports number 45. That slide job attempt, an opportunity now for Carson Macedo to close in on the leading contender for the Kevin Gobrecht Award. White flag set to wave on this evening's Toyota Dash. Giovanni Selzy works his way through 1 and 2 and down the back straightaway. He won the last time the World of Outlaws visited 2 years ago. He'll start on the pole tonight. Hot Sauce wins the Toyota Dash. Landon Brooks finishes second. Third goes to Buddy Copeway and Carson Macedo fourth, and Logan Schuart and Dylan Bloomfield. Official order of finish for this evening's Toyota Dash. Giovanni Selzy the winner in the 18. Second the 45 of Landon Brooks. Third the 83 of Buddy Copeway. Fourth the 41 of Carson Macedo. Fifth the 1S of Logan Schuart. And in sixth the 83. lights out around the Bakersfield Speedway. Toyota pace truck to the infield. Zerfoss, Jamie Veal bring us very slowly to the stripe. And now to the green flag in the Microlite Last Chance Showdown. Battle for second into turns 3 and 4 as Brock Zerfoss leads to Jamie Veal and Caden Steele going at it for their runner-up position. Steele to the inside of Veal, slides up the racetrack. A little bit of a wheel stand there. Veal trying to come back to his inside. Caden Steele second as they complete lap number 2 of 12 in the Microlite Last Chance Showdown. Brock Zerfoss out in front by 1 3/4 seconds. Dawson Faria in the 12B occupying the final transfer spot, and Garrett Williamson in hot pursuit as they cross the start-finish line. Williamson on the outside looking in now, runs to the top of the speedway. Faria up over the inside berm. He's off the pace. A problem for the 12B. And he'll pull into the infield. We stay under green flag conditions. That'll move Garrett Williamson into the sixth and final transfer spot. Dominic Gordon trying to get a run on Garrett Williamson for the transfer spot, but still some 6 car lengths short as we reach the halfway point of the Microlite Last Chance Showdown. Off the pace! Problems for Brock Zerfoss, the race leader, slowing on the back straightaway. Brock Zerfoss slows on the inside access road. Caution flag waves. Back to green at the cone on the front stretch with 5 laps remaining in the Microlite Last Chance Showdown. Caden Steele now the leader. Jamie Veal running second as we come to the green. Veal to the inside looking for the top spot. Can't quite make it happen at 1 and 2. Garrett Williamson battling with Dominic Gordon. They get very close out of turn 4. Williamson retains 5th, but Gordon is right there with him to the inside in 1 and 2. Dominic Gordon to the inside of Garrett Williamson, slides up the banking. Williamson crosses back underneath him and retains 5th. 3 laps to go and another slide jump exchange of positions in 1 and 2 between 10 of Dominic Gordon and the 23 of Garrett Williamson. Waving for Caden Steele in the 121. Backstretch into 3 and 4 for the final time. Caden Steele will win the Microlite Last Chance Showdown. Second goes to Jamie Veal. Craig Kinzer comes home third. Austin McCormick fourth. Fifth to Garrett Williamson and Dominic Gordon in. They've done to entertain you here this evening. Bakersfield Speedway, you wanted the best. You got them 4 abreast, often imitated, never duplicated. The greatest show on dirt, the world of outlaws, NOS Energy Drink Sprint Cup. The green flag waves on the Nashville West Showdown at Bakersfield Speedway. Early leader Giovanni Sozzi, but now problems. Landon Brooks sideways collects 3 other cars or more. A lot of cars now tangled up in turn number 2, and the red flag will wave. 8 cars stopped in turn 2. Sheldon Hodenschild, Landon Crawley, Tim Kading, Jamie Veal, DJ Netto, Landon Brooks, Bill Balog, and Craig Kinzer. And it started when Landon Brooks got sideways into turn 2. Look at the Dirt Vision replay. see Brooks get up out of the groove. The car snapped around hard to the left. And then no place for anyone else to go. Landon Crawley the first to make contact. But again, just absolute chaos behind them. Damage to the left front corner of the 45 for Landon Brooks. A flat left rear tire on DJ Netto's car. Left rear tire damage for the 45 as well. Again, Bill Balog sitting there. Eight cars involved in the accident. We wave the green flag at Bakersfield as they race into turn one. Giovanni Selzy down low. Buddy Copeboyd up high. Selzy leads at the end of the backstretch. Copeboyd takes a peek to the inside. Not enough room for a slider to work there. Gio leads lap number one. David Gravel all over Logan Schuart. A race for the fourth spot. Schuart goes to the cushion and gets a run on third place. Carson Messina. Now Schuart dives to the inside at three and four. Logan Schuart can't hold the low line. Side by side, Dominic Selzy, Donnie Schatz, both of them closing in on Dylan Bloomfield. Bloomfield runs in the seventh spot. They race wheel to wheel for eighth. Schatz and Dominic Selzy going at it. Schatz has the spot into turn three. Selzy tries to turn hard to the left underneath him and can't make the pass out of corner number four. Now Donnie Schatz setting his sights on Dylan Bloomfield. Giovanni Selzy leading it with four laps complete. Buddy Copeboyd staying within striking distance. Traffic about to be a factor for your race leader. Copeboyd to the inside! Slide job led momentarily. Selzy able to cross back underneath him. Buddy Copeboyd led for about 60 feet in turn two. Copeboyd again with a slider in one and two, but Selzy stays on the throttle and fends off the charge again. And now traffic officially in play as they make their way into turns three and four. Directly in front of the race leader is the 88 of Austin McCarl. Selzy thought about going around McCarl on the outside, now looks to the inside entering turn three. Copeboyd stays to the top looking for a run on the leader in heavy traffic into turn one. Buddy Copeboyd, wheel to wheel. Giovanni Selzy still stays in the top spot down the back straightaway. Selzy to the inside of Landon Crawley and Craig Kinzer. Copeboyd now held up and breathing room now for the 18. Copeboyd right back to the inside and a glimpse there of the 41 of Carson Messina, who looks for an opportunity while running in the third spot. 10 of 35 laps complete as they cross the line. Logan Schuart continuing to stay with the 41, and now the race for the lead. He's up once again. Copeboyd to the inside. Giovanni Selzy crosses back underneath him. 11 laps down. Here's Copeboyd looking for the lead again. He's got it in turn two. Again, Selzy tries to come back underneath him, but Buddy Copeboyd leads into turn three. Selzy's turn to try the slider, and it sticks in turn four. Giovanni Selzy maintains the lead. Copeboyd had it for half a lap that time. Giovanni Selzy, Buddy Copeboyd exchanging the lead in the corners, but officially Selzy has led all 13 laps so far. Copeboyd again within a car length and a half of the number 18. Giovanni Selzy dives down to the inside of Lockie McDonough, and now Copeboyd to the inside at the end of the back straightaway. 15 laps down, 20 laps to go at the Bakersfield Speedway. A bit of breathing room for the leaders before they catch the back of the field once again. Giovanni Selzy leads it. Buddy Copeboyd is second. Carson Messina runs third. Logan Schuart fourth. David Gravel is fifth. Cole Messina sixth. Dylan Bloomfield seventh. Donnie Schatz eighth. Dominic Selzy ninth. And Chuck Goodyear in tenth. Heavy traffic once again for the race leaders as Giovanni Selzy tries to slide up in front of Jamie Veal. Veal comes back to his inside. Here's the opportunity for Copeboyd down low at 3 and 4. But Veal is there and Selzy maintains the race lead. Again, the traffic is thick in front of the race leader, trying to work his way by the 10 of Dominic Gordon. who has a moment on the cushion, and so does Buddy Kilfoyd. And now in the picture once again, Carson Macedo. Top three, nearly nose to tail in traffic as they work into turns three and four. 20 laps complete across the line. Kilfoyd looking for a run. Here's Macedo, the top three, now battle for the lead into turn three. On the speedway, Dylan Bloomfield stopped bottom of turn number three. Gio gets on the throttle and we go back to green flag action at Bakersfield. Carson Macedo comes to second, getting around Buddy Kilfoyd, and looks for the lead. Red flag conditions. Of course, upside down in turn one. DJ Netto involved, as is the six of Lockie McDonough. Red flag conditions again at Bakersfield Speedway. Safety crew tending to the 88. We have 15 laps remaining in the Nashville West Showdown for the World Outlaws NOS Energy Drink Sprint Car Series, and Giovanni Selzy brings us back to green flag conditions. Kilfoyd down low. Selzy powers between the 83 and the wall to maintain the lead. Carson Macedo, a peek to the inside of Kilfoyd, but can't hold that low line. An opportunity now for the Shark Racing 1S Logan Schuhart trying to close in on the 41 out of turn two. Macedo able to hang on to the third spot. Giovanni Selzy with the right rear on the cushion, which is right up against the wall. Now David Gravel to the inside of Logan Schuhart. Move David Gravel into fourth. David Gravel up to the fourth spot now as Buddy Kilfoyd continues his relentless pursuit of race leader Giovanni Selzy. Again, traffic will be a factor fairly quickly on this tight bull ring. And this time, as they enter traffic in turns three and four, there are 10 laps to go. Selzy stretching it out just a bit, 3/4 of a second to lead the last time across the line. But now heavier traffic in front of that orange number 18. And Kilfoyd trying to capitalize, getting closer to the inside for the lead. Buddy Kilfoyd, he's got it for the moment. Selzy right back to the inside, but Kilfoyd hangs on into turn three. New race leader Buddy Kilfoyd on lap number 28. Caution on the speedway. Car slowing in turn three. Shelton Hutton, Shelton in the number 17. Kilfoyd. Green flag conditions. Kilfoyd gets a fantastic restart. Carson Macedo a peek to the inside, but can't grab the second spot away from Giovanni Selzy. Cole Macedo now looking at the battle between David Gravel and the 1S of Logan Schuhart. Schuhart back around Gravel. Logan Schuhart now back into fourth. And Cole Macedo dives to the inside of the points leader looking for fifth. He's gone for the moment. Gravel crosses back underneath him. Laps to go for Buddy Kilfoyd out in front, pulling away from Giovanni Selzy. But again, barring a caution flag, there should be traffic within that 5 laps. And now making 4 a little less down the back straightaway. Rock Motorsports 83. Three laps to go. going into turn one. The move to the inside of Jamie View. Stays in front of the 17AU. Back straightaway for the final time. Buddy Kofoid's hot streak continues at Bakersfield Speedway. He wins the Nashville West Showdown. Giovanni Salzi comes home second. Corson Macino third. Logan Shuart fourth. And David Gravel in fifth. Top 10 would look like this. Buddy Kofoid with the win. Giovanni Selzy second.